Hi, and welcome to this video about the Loan Payoff Schedule. You can purchase this spreadsheet on my shop product page, shop.mommoneymap.com, which I'll link to below, but you can also just watch this video to get inspired about how to pay off your mortgage faster. This video goes over the Loan Payoff Schedule in Excel, but there's also a Google Sheets version. I'll include all the links below. Just to confirm, this spreadsheet will help you to create a loan amortization schedule for a mortgage, car loan, student loan, or other loan type with a fixed interest rate and regular payment. This spreadsheet is handy to see how extra payments toward your principal will impact your loan payoff date. Two important notes, it will not work with credit cards. If you're looking for a spreadsheet that will automatically reorder your credit card debts to create an optimal payment plan, I have a separate debt payoff calculator, which I'll link to below. Also, this loan payoff schedule is not a tracker in the sense that you can enter in your payment every month as you pay it off, and it will create an update report. It automatically generates a schedule of your payments, including your payments towards your principal and interest. Now, jumping into the loan payoff schedule, here are the areas that are editable. So this part here where you would enter in all of your loan and payment details, as well as this extra payment column. And then finally, this date cell where you can enter in your most recent payment date. So how do you use the spreadsheet? When you first open up the spreadsheet, you have to fill in all of these editable areas. The loan amount is your outstanding balance and not your original balance. That's assuming you've already started paying into your mortgage. So it'll probably not be a round number like this. It'll probably be something like this instead. The annual interest rate is the next cell you have to enter in. So I'm just gonna put in a random one there. The loan period, this is in years. This is the original amortization, the length of time it will take to fully pay off your loan with the scheduled regular payments. It's usually between 1 to 30 years. And I should probably note this is different from the actual amortization remaining, which is the amount of months or years remaining in your loan. The payment frequency, this is how frequently you make payments per year. You can select an option here in the dropdown. The first payment date, this is the first date you make a payment on your loan. However, if you've already started paying off your loan, you should enter in the next payment due date because this would then reflect what your actual outstanding balance is. The interest compound period, you have to enter in an option here. The interest compound period is the number of times that interest is compounded per year. In the US, mortgages are compounded monthly, and in Canada, the mortgages are compounded semi-annually. If you're outside of the US and Canada, definitely double check what your interest compound period is for your loan. After filling in all this information, you'll notice that an auto-populated scheduled payment per period will appear. And this is the regular payment you'll pay per period, as well as the scheduled number of payments, which is the total number of payments you'll make over the entire loan period if you don't make extra payments. You might notice that this is different from your actual scheduled payment, and that might be because you're on an accelerated plan. If you pay, say, like regularly $1,000 a month, then you'll have to account for that by entering in the difference in the extra payment section. And then you'll have to auto-populate that down until there is no balance showing. Just gonna scroll down. Oopsies, that's likely. So here, now this will reflect the actual payment date that the loan will be paid off because these extra payments now reflect what you're actually paying each month. If you want to enter in extra payments in addition to these, you can always enter it in. Say you're making an extra $1,000 payment. You'll see that everything will auto-update like that. And as you progress through your payments, you can enter in your most recent payment date. This date has to be a date that is in the payment date column. So, for example, this date here. And once you enter in this date, you'll see that all of this information here, what you've paid thus far, what's remaining, what the total is, what the payoff date will be, and your progress towards paying down this loan, all of that will auto-update to reflect this most recent payment date. If you buy the product, there are more extensive PDF instructions with screenshots that I encourage you to read through, as there's more information about the details, best practices, and frequently asked questions. Let me know if you have any additional questions in the comments or shooting me an email. Thanks for watching this video.